6. This is number 6 in the series. And believe me, I know. I filmed all these on one night. I know that people have already hurled Rotten Tomatoes. Tell me how much they hate the series because it's so self-centered and not challenging and boring and saying the same thing over. That's what people are saying. And I know this in the past because I filmed all 11 on the same night. All right, but here we go. So number 6 is unconventional. I'm asking, am I unconventional? Because I realize that a man with a full head of hair, if he's too conventional, too predictable, he's not going to be cool and he's not going to be liked. So something that my identity is built on is being unconventional. It always has been. And it's part of my personality because I don't cater to peer pressure like most people do. I don't have that fear of not being loved or liked by people because I care so much about my own version of truth that I'm going to do whatever I want to do, and whoever wants to join me can. And for the people who don't, that's cool too. They can do whatever their truth is. And if it's doing what everyone else does, that's fine. That's what they want to do. But as for me, I'm not. I've always been unconventional. And let's face it, if I wasn't, would this channel be successful? I don't think so. I think the fact that I am unconventional in the way that I deal with hair loss makes me successful as a YouTuber to be able to have over 5,000 subscribers when I still have this much hair, which some would argue is too many to have a successful hair loss channel. But I am unconventional about it all. Why? Because while I do cater to people who want to see products featured, the main thing I spend most of my time on is hair loss psychology. And there's just not enough people regularly talking about that on YouTube from a positive perspective. As in, you can get through this, you can get over it, and you can even do it without even spending any money or going through some kind of surgery or drugs or whatever it is. You can actually do it from within if you know how to change your perspective and know that feelings turn into facts. But you can actually control your feelings, which will therefore have a direct effect on what the facts are. I'm unconventional. I'm weird. I'm not normal. But I've always been that way, and that's not an insult to me. It's a compliment. So it's important that you're offbeat. Not weird, not too weird, but a little bit like, oh, well, that guy's interesting because he's saying this or he's doing this, and I never would have thought about that, but that's actually pretty cool. I think I might do that thing or think that thing. So that's what being unconventional is all about. So in closing for this video, I'm reminding you what the point of these videos is. You can have a perfect head of hair, but if you're so vanilla, you're so predictable, you're so by the book, sure enough, you're going to be showed up by another guy over here who's completely bald, but he's cooler just because he has different ideas and does different things aside from the mainstream that everyone else is doing. He's going to be cooler and actually, in theory, more attractive and desired because of that.